Distinguished guests to the graduation ceremonies for the class of 2023. As luck would have it, a piping plover has laid eggs on the turf field. We have placed a protective green barricade around her nest. Please try your best not to disturb this area. And now, on to our graduation ceremony. Today brings to a close a very important chapter in the lives of a wonderful array of young men and women. Over the last 4 years, so many things have changed. You entered through these doors as young, meek, scared freshmen, hit with a worldwide pandemic, and the remainder of your school year practically being canceled. Your sophomore year consisted of hybrid learning days and mask wearing. Your junior year returned to a sense of normal, but ultimately, it was your senior year that returned us all to a place of full normal. You certainly were dealt your fair share of curveballs, but today, you stand before me older, more mature, more resilient, more confident, and ready and eager to take on the next stage of life. As you move forward and come face to face with your future, I'd like to share a single piece of advice I learned from my new friend, Mrs. Fisher. Her son, Evan, would have been graduating with you today, and she came across a saying that we both believe Evan would have wanted to share with you. Anything you do, do it well. The last thing you want is to be sorry for what you did not do. So, my friends, don't ever be afraid of trying. If you fail, you have learned valuable information that will inevitably help you as you move forward. Be tenacious, be brave, be bold. Go out there and show this world just what you are made of. This is your day, the day you have worked so hard to achieve, and I am truly proud of each and every one of you. Enjoy your day and congratulations. At this time, please welcome Miss Victoria Sullivan, treasurer of the class of 2023, to the podium to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the playing of the national anthem. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Jack Werb, salutatorian of the class of 2023.
Good evening. I'd like to take this time to welcome all the distinguished guests, faculty, staff, school committee, friends, family, and most importantly, the class of 2023. Before I start, I think it's important to thank those who helped us get where we are today. A thank you to our teachers who have guided us throughout the past 12 years. And a big thank you to our friends and family who have supported us through every step of the way. Big shout out to Mom, Dad, and Haley over there. When they asked me to write this welcome address, it got me thinking of the very idea of welcoming. More specifically, I began thinking about my own experience with BR. In eighth grade, I got the opportunity to join the BR swim team. I'm gonna be honest, I was worried. What would the other kids think of me? Would they even like me? It's safe to say that I was really nervous that first day of practice. Yet, my worries could not have been more misplaced. The coach simply put me in a lane with a mix of sophomores and seniors. And while I feared they wouldn't speak to me, everyone introduced themselves almost immediately. They made sure to talk to me during the entire practice so I never felt left out. And they didn't just do that for the first couple practices, the first week, or even the first month. Even at pasta parties throughout the whole year, where they could have ditched me to hang out with their high school friends, they didn't. And if that doesn't shout welcoming, I don't know what does. Now, when I got to freshman year, it was clear that this welcoming attitude wasn't held only by the swim team. I joined a few clubs, like the math team and science Olympiad, and both made me feel like a part of the team that very first day. Now, 4 years ago, being from different towns, none of us knew most of the rest of us. Yet, we welcomed each other. People who I didn't know now are now some of my best friends. And I'm willing to bet that most of you have had a similar experience. Speaking of experiences, we've shared many great ones throughout the past 4 years. For example, going into school every morning and seeing that nice man, Richard, sharing his peace sign and handing out those little cards. Or walking through the parking lots and seeing Miss Peach frantically blowing fun tunes on her whistle and waving around to stop traffic. There were also quite a few memorable moments from that whole hybrid learning fiasco. For those of you who don't know what that was like, you'd video call into our classes from home. From teachers taking 20 minutes to pull up one paper over Google Meets, to learning every detail of your classmate's wall, and sometimes meeting their siblings in the backgrounds, or pets like my dog Charlie showing up to math class, you never knew what to expect. Once we came back to school, there was all that contact tracing. To give you a sense of that one, you'd be sitting in class, and then all of a sudden, every person within a two-desk radius of you would just disappear. And you'd just wonder whether or not they had COVID, or you just smelled really, really bad. Then, later, you'd go out on mass breaks, where we'd be crushed together in the back of the school. It's a real good thing that everyone did, in fact, take showers and have good hygiene. Regardless of all that, we've made it. To be sitting here now is an incredible accomplishment. You've survived four of the greatest years of your life. Every all-nighter, every sip of coffee, every can of Red Bull, every lengthy 20-page email sent have all been worth it. Everything has led up to that moment, and now that moment is here. As we move forward into the next chapter of our lives, we must keep that very same idea of welcoming on the forefront of our minds. You are going to meet many people from many different places and backgrounds. You never know what someone is going through. But if you just reach out and try to be welcoming to them, you never know how you might change their lives or find a new best friend. I'll remember my time here at BR with you fondly, and we'd like to end this by wishing you all the best of luck in your futures. Now, let's have some fun.
At this time, I am honored to welcome the class of 2023 speaker, Mr. David Patrick, to the podium.
Okay, so I wanted to differentiate my speech, so I made two different ones, but I'm told that I only have enough time for one, so you're gonna have to choose, do you want A or B? A? Okay. It's short. Before the speech, an announcement. Somebody parked in my spot, number 44, over in the back parking lot. Please go move your car immediately or it'll be towed. Mr. Ringette, can you get on that, please? No, only kidding. Okay, but look, you're not teachers yet. When you do become a teacher, you're more than welcome to my spot. All right. And I will, but really, you know, you folks are teachers in a way, okay? Because you taught me a lot. You've taught me mostly, you taught me about yourselves, and you taught me about your generation. It's important. So here are my top three things that I've learned about you. One, you're compassionate. Two, you care deeply about a lot of different things, and that's good. And three, you love your family and friends. And all of those are great qualities. Now, if you, both individually and collectively, and as a generation, commit to working hard, and if you're determined, I'm telling you that every obstacle that you may confront can be overcome, every one of them. All of the challenges that humanity in this world face can be solved, every one of them. So, take those fantastic qualities that you have and believe in your heart and in your soul, that if you work hard and you are determined, you can make a difference in this world. You really can. Nothing is impossible. Some more advice. And I believe I first heard this from Dr. Phil on a podcast. And it has to do with this. This thing. Don't be afraid to put it down every now and then. Excuse me. Stop glorifying the lives of others and stop comparing your own life to others through tickety-tock, snap face, and Instatube. Go out there and live your own life. Because I'm telling you, life can be a beautiful thing. It can be a great thing. But you have to go out there and you have to live it. And when you do, you're going to find that this world that we live in is filled with great places and great people. You find that our world still has a lot to offer you. So go out there and get it. I truly believe that everyone has some type of superpower. Find it. Use it for the good of humanity, this planet, and for yourselves. I found that the relationship between humanity and this planet is very special. Simply put, it's a complex miracle. And I can guarantee you that both are worth being part of, both are worth working hard for, and both are worth saving. Don't wait. Because time, all of our time here, is short. And I know that can be a hard thing to comprehend when you're young. So make the most of it. Make the most of your time. Enjoy your time. And don't waste it. As you age, you're going to find that time is the most valuable thing that you have. More so than any amount of money. More so than any possession that you may have. So remember, the money, the possessions can always be replaced, but the time that you have here cannot. Lastly, I'd like to leave you with this, and I think I can speak for most of the adults here, teachers, administrators, parents, I'm one of them, relatives and friends. I want you to know this, that most of the things that we do for you, we put you through school, we educate you, we try and raise you to know right from wrong, we try to prepare you for the world that's in front of you. We celebrate your accomplishments, like this graduation here today. And the reason why we do all of this for you is because we love you. Now go out there and spread some of that love. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to welcome Mr. Liam Berry, president of the class of 2023, to the microphone.
Good evening, parents, teachers, administrators, family members, and most importantly, the Bridgewater-Raynham graduating class of 2023. My name is Liam Barry, and it is truly an honor to speak to you all today as class president, vice president of National Honor Society, and Mr. BR, runner-up. I would just like to start off by giving a long-awaited apology to those who have been expecting a second pretzel machine to be installed in our beloved cafeteria since middle school. The guilt I have felt from this situation pains me like nothing else. Now that I have that off my chest, hopefully I can now be taken seriously by the ones who have held this grudge against me for years. Well, my fellow classmates, our journey together has been rather unorthodox to say the least, but there are useful skills we've developed and positive lessons we have learned over the years. I would just like to take you back to sophomore year, where half of everyone's faces were covered up. One-way hallways forced students to create roadmaps just to get to class. Miss Beach sneaking up once in a while with a tape measure just to make sure you and your classmate weren't breathing on each other anywhere closer than 6 feet apart. In classrooms on Google Meets, where it was a rare occurrence to see a student with a camera on. We were able to persevere and wake up at exactly 7:25 to log onto our first period class and raise our hands for attendance by just clicking a button. Who knew that showing up to BR 2 days a week, having a half day, then flipping open a laptop would be so difficult. Going through these times forced us to use technology like we never had to previously. Our high school careers have taught us that hardships will come at us unexpectedly. We have proven to ourselves that we can overcome any challenge. Through the pandemic, we've learned that the only constant in life is change. Whether we like it or not, life will come at you fast and is up to us to determine our futures. A main lesson that I've personally learned through my high school experience is that you need to become comfortable with being uncomfortable. Now leaving high school, we face the real world and are uncertain of what the future holds for us. Stepping out of our comfort zone can only lead to positive results and personal growth. If you feel as if you need an extra push to take that risk, just think back to what we went through in our early high school years and how we managed to overcome something that seemed unthinkable. We have proven to ourselves that we can excel under difficult and unusual circumstances, so don't doubt yourself. Try something new, even if you are unsure. At our age, it is easy to be dissuaded by friends and social media. Don't let that hold you back. As Travis Scott once said, how are you gonna knock somebody in the world for trying to do something? Since when has it become not cool to try? Surround yourself with people who cheer you on and genuinely want to see you succeed. If taking a risk means that you have the opportunity to be happier, then take the risk. Set small, manageable goals to outline achievement and maintain confidence, which will eventually lead to success. Robert Collier defines success by saying, success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in and day out. If you can stay motivated and trust the process, good things will come. Every small interaction you have had with the people around you has impacted someone more than you may realize. Also knows the butterfly effect, which is the idea that small things can have non-linear impacts on a complex system. The concept is imagined with the butterfly flapping its wings and causing a typhoon. As we stand on the precipice of the future, the world beckons with its boundless possibilities. Each one of us possesses unique talents, passions, and dreams that will shape the course of our lives. We may choose whether it be pursuing higher education, entering the workforce, or embarking on a personal journey, but we all share a common foundation rooted in the lessons we have learned at Bridgewater-Raynham. In closing, I want to express my deepest pride and admiration for the class of 2023. We have grown together, laughed together, and created memories that will forever be etched in our hearts. As we step into the world as graduates of Bridgewater-Raynham, let us embrace the challenges, seize the opportunities, and make our mark on this ever-changing world. Congratulations, class of 2023. May your journey be filled with joy, success, and an unwavering determination to make a difference. I can't wait to see how you all succeed in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Liam. At this time, please join me in welcoming the superintendent, Mr. Ryan Powers, with the superintendent's recognition of scholastic achievement and acknowledgments.
Good evening. I'd like to welcome all our families, friends, staff members, and special guests. Your continued support of our students is appreciated and commendable. It is my honor to start by recognizing the top three students in the class of 2023. Miss Susanna Haley is ranked number three in her class. While at BR, yes, absolutely. While at BR, Susanna has been a member of several extracurricular activities, including the National Honor Society, the Art Club, where she was elected co-president, and Rainwater, where she is the stage manager of the musical productions. In addition, she was selected for both the Art and Math Department Awards for Excellence and Achievement. She has earned several accolades for her amazing artistic ability, including a nomination to show her art among the college art students at the Bridgewater State University Art Show. Outside of school, Susanna has earned both her bronze and silver medals for her community service projects with the Girl Scouts. In addition to her high academic achievement and involvement in activities, she is a kind and inspirational individual who is truly talented in the arts. Susanna will be attending Savannah College of Art and Design in the fall and has an interest in majoring in film and television production and production design. Congratulations, Susanna. Jack Werb. Mr. Jack Werb is ranked number 2 in his class. While at Bridgewater-Raynham, Jack has been president of the National Honor Society, treasurer of the freshman class vice president, the 10th grade, 11th grade, and 12th grade, math team treasurer, member of the Science Olympiad team, and captain and MVP of the swim team. Additionally, Jack has been recognized for his academics by receiving the Certificate of Academic Excellence by the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents, the BR Math Academic Award, the BR Physical Education Award, and being named an Academic All-American in swimming. Outside of school, Jack is a Little League umpire, swim instructor, and lifeguard. Jack's commitment to the students and the community of Bridgewater and Raynham has been outstanding, and he will definitely leave a void. Jack will be attending Worcester Polytechnic Institute, majoring in aerospace engineering. Congratulations, Jack. Tiffany Semexon. Miss Tiffany Semexon is ranked number 1 in her class. While at BR, Tiffany has been a member of the National Honor Society, vice president of the Science Olympiad, stage manager for the Rainwater Players, a DICE youth advisor, and vice president of the Cybersecurity Club. Additionally, she has received the Superintendent's Award, Principal's Award, and was the recipient of an AP Scholar Award. Outside of school, Tiffany volunteers as an elder companion and is a talented dancer and piano player. Tiffany is very involved as a student leader who's been the perfect role model for our underclassmen, working with them as a math interventionist, AP leader, and at our freshman orientations. The students and faculty will truly miss her presence at BR. Tiffany will also be attending Worcester Polytechnic Institute in the fall and majoring in computer science. Congratulations, Tiffany. To the graduates of the class of 2023, I have to start by apologizing. The best part of senior year is the fact you don't have to make up any snow days. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to make that happen for you. I truly am sorry. I commend you on your efforts, though. Matthew would relay all of your snow day requests to me. Very creative and well done. Speaking of Matthew, I did promise him I would not share any embarrassing stories. However, I do want to say how awesome it is to stand up here as your dad. I thought it was pretty special to be your principal when you started kindergarten. Never did I imagine I would be your superintendent at your graduation. 30 years ago in 1993, I graduated from high school. While those 30 years have gone by in a flash, I've learned a few things along the way that I'd like to share with you tonight. First, life isn't always going to be easy or fair, but the challenges you face will strengthen your grit, your determination, and your character. Second, wake up each morning with a full heart. Love what you do and love those around you. Be kind to all. Last and most important, never be complacent. Continue to grow and learn and be the best version of yourself. In closing, you're all amazing young adults. Be proud of your accomplishments, but know the best is yet to come. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Powers. At this time, we would like to take a moment to recognize members of the class of 2023 who are bound for military training after graduation. Will the following seniors please stand as I call your names and remain standing? Tyreek Baptista, United States Marines. Ryan Conroy, United States Air Force. Cameron Davidson, United States Coast Guard. Christopher Hogue, United States Coast Guard. Thomas Martirosian, United States Marines. Jesse McNeil, United States Air Force Academy. Tina Profity, a United States Air Force. Dominic Saro, United States Army. Cameron Taranjo, United States Air Force. On behalf of everyone here, we thank you for your dedication, commitment, and willingness to serve. May God bless you and keep you safe. At this time, I am honored to invite the valedictorian of the class of 2023, Ms. Tiffany Semexent, to the podium to give the farewell address.
A few weeks ago, I was asked to deliver the valedictorian's speech. A farewell address, a goodbye, a departure from all that we've known, discovered, and made. But how do you say goodbye to 4 years, to 13 years, to essentially your whole life? How do you summarize, finalize, and leave behind the memories you've made and garnered in your time here? There are 298 of us here today, 298 of us who will leave and enter a new phase of our lives. The hallways, classrooms, and stairwells that we spent endless time memorizing will no longer be part of our routine. For some, it may be easy. The calling of what's to come is exciting and alluring, a chance to leave behind any of the bad memories and start fresh, an opportunity to become the person you were always meant to be. It's not a departure from all that we know, but a venture into something new and thrilling. For some, it may be difficult, as changes often are. The familiarity, the routine, the comfort are to be left behind. You don't know what lies ahead, and you'll miss what you are leaving. To change and leave is to enter something new and to part from what you've spent so much time adjusting to. Whether you're ready to leave or hesitant to leave things behind, whether you're rearing to venture or afraid of departing, we have one last night together where we aren't doing either. In this moment, we are between leaving and starting, between departing and venturing. For tonight, and for likely the last time, we are together as one class, experiencing the same event, the same moment. There are 298 of us here, 298 different memories and stories, 298 lives, unique lives, shared lives, lives separate, intertwined. 298 of us who will no longer be a part of a collective 298, but will become a singular one. To those of you who are scared of departing, I encourage you to look forward to what you're venturing into. Your life is now full of possibility. You have the power in your hands to create the future you want for yourself. And for those of you who are all too ready to depart, I encourage you to look back at what you are departing from. It's not likely that you'll miss some of your classes or school policies, but I hope that you'll miss the laughter you shared with friends or the memories you hold dearest to you. It's customary and almost obligatory that I thank a whole list of people, teachers, administrators, parents, faculty. I'm supposed to thank them for their hard work and for helping us get here. Instead, I would like to encourage my peers in this moment to think about someone that they couldn't have gotten here without, someone who is instrumental to their journey. Think about them and thank them before you leave here, before you depart, before you venture. When you all walk across the stage and are handed your diploma, I hope you feel nothing but joy and pride. 4 years, 13 years, have led you to this exact moment. After tonight, your high school career will be officially concluded. So congratulations, Bridgewater-Raynham class of 2023, and farewell. Here's to departing, here's to venturing.
We ready?
At this time, I am honored to present the class of 2023.
Our first recipient, Liam David Berry. Jack Benjamin Werb. Victoria Rose Sullivan. Rocco Charles Ricciotti. Tiffany Taylor Samexent. Susanna Lynn Haley. Jennifer Caitlin Abreu. Julia Marie Aker. Megan Elizabeth Alden. Caleb Liberato Lee Alencar. Emily Ann Allen. Marcus James Almeida. Kevin Ubdallah Almaskawi. Nalisa Ribeiro Andrade. Bassam Audi. Natika August. Francesca May Azevedo. Mia Francesca Balsamo. Sage Mary Balsamo. Chase William Balutis. Ellie Elizabeth Balutis. Lily Marie Balutis. Sila Anna Salud Thompson Banez. Adrian Antonio Banos Gomez. Haley Ruth Banville. Tyreek Prien Baptista. Emma Kate Barron. Isabella Marie Barrett. Luke Patrick Barry. Samantha Callie Bean. Michaela Mary Belmonte. Aya Benwardia. Caden James Bento. Gina Marie Berry. Evan James Betzker. Noah Christopher Bird. Sean Patrick Blackton. Talia Evelyn Blake. Brooke Ashley Beener. Brandon John Boucher. Natalia Virginia Brown. Olivia Jordan Bucella. Jacob Nicholas Buckley. Jeffrey Mason Biot. Hannah Marie Burr. JC Kyra Campbell. Madison Naomi Campbell. Kendall Marie Carbono. Jonathan Ricardo Chacon Lazo. Cade Michael Chaka. Aiden Floyd Chu. Joshua Scott Clifford. Jake Thomas Clarity. McKenna Lee Columbus.
Jake, congratulations.
Annalise Claire Colwell.
McKenna, congratulations.
Marlena Catherine Colwell.
Annalise, congratulations.
Brinley Ann Compton.
Marlena, congratulations.
Patrick William Concannon. Macy Elizabeth Conlin. Jesse Jean Connors. Ryan Joseph Conroy. Jason Neil Coughlin. Morgan Brianna Corsi. Alexis Elizabeth Courtney.
Morgan, congratulations.
Daniel James Cox. Jeffrey Franklin Coyle.
Nice job, DJ. Congratulations, buddy.
Abigail Rose Cruz.
Congratulations, Jeff.
Jordan Elizabeth Cullinane. Liam Joseph Cummings. Katerina Marie Cunliffe.
Congratulations.
Christian James Curley.
Congratulations.
Hannah Catherine Daly.
Congratulations, Christian.
Sean James Daly.
Congratulations.
Arthur Yeethai Don.
Congratulations, Sean.
Alfred Robert Dengsowitz III.
Arthur, congratulations.
Cameron Anthony Davidson.
Congratulations.
Jessica Elena Davis.
Good job, Cam. Super proud of you.
Marin Gloria Davis. Margaret Connor Day. Matthew David Joseph Dean.
Margaret, congratulations.
Logan Burrell Danoon.
Matthew, congratulations.
Damian Manuel D'Souza.
Great job.
Shawanda Diudone.
Damian, nice job, buddy.
Angelo Michael DiPlacido. Connor William Donahue. Sean Michael Donahue.
Congratulations.
Molly Judith Donna.
Sean, congratulations.
Isaiah Linville Ainsley Dos Passos.
Molly, congratulations.
Asaf Ferreira Souza Dos Santos. Connor Dylan Downing.
Congratulations.
Kevin John Doyle.
Congratulations.
Gianna Adalis Duran.
Kevin, congratulations.
Kenneth Gregory Egan. Samuel Joseph Ehrenzweig. Anthony Michael Faraz.
Congratulations, Sam. Thanks.
Mia Skyla Figueroa.
Anthony, congratulations.
Emma Catherine Flaherty.
Congratulations.
Eric Bronson Flynn.
Congratulations, Emma.
Marissa Nicole Flynn. Maya Maureen Foley. Vincent John Forcucci.
Congratulations.
Lily Ann Ford.
Vincent, congratulations.
John Paul Forrester.
Lily, congratulations.
Daniel Thomas Francis.
John, congratulations. Thank you.
Bradley Thomas Frazier. Kate Jessica Freeman.
Evan Thomas Gagnon. Emma Delaney Gardner.
Congratulations, Evan. Good job.
Jack Andrew Gentile. Nico Alexander Georgikopoulos. Kira Elizabeth Georgikakis.
Nico, congratulations. Thank you.
Brady Patrick Gingell. Olivia Rose Jelsvik. Jacob Edward Golden. Brendan Robert Goonan. Alexandria Helen Grant. Naomi Francis Grant. Gavin Michael Gray. Emma Rose Grimes.
Good job, buddy.
Braden James Hackett. Jessica Kara Valentine Hansen. Gwendolyn Lou Hansen. Michael Patrick Harrington. Ethan James Hastings. Eli Coleman Henshin.
Ethan, congratulations.
Caitlin Ann Hess.
Congratulations, Eli.
Declan William Hetrick. Kylie Rache Hicks.
Congratulations, Declan.
James Allen Hoffman.
Congratulations, Scott. Best of luck.
Cameron Alexander Hogue.
James, congratulations.
Christopher Aaron Hogue.
Congratulations.
William Robert Hoggrell. Terry Teves Holder. Isabella Brooke Raposo Holland. Allison Lee Hopkins. Ava Marie Dina Hoyo. Madison Rose Ingargiola. Jaden Robert Jean.
Madison, congratulations.
Jaleo Ricardo Jean.
Jaden, congratulations.
Delonte Anthony Jenkins.
Jaleo, congratulations.
Dylan Richard Jewett. Rudvon Joseph.
Dylan, congratulations.
Thank you. Kiefer Willis Jewell.
Congratulations. Best of luck.
Colin Keith Kearns. Sonia Katua. Emerson Grace Kilsby. Caitlin Paige Lolly.
Good job, Emerson. Congratulations.
Jack Harrison Lambert.
Caitlin, congratulations. Best of luck.
Kevin Michael Lambert.
Good job, Jack. Congratulations.
Nathan Redding Leach.
Kevin, congratulations. Best of luck.
Joseph Philip LeCayer. Jamal David Lee Jr.
Hey, I'm proud of you that you made it. Good job, okay, right? Keep up the good work.
Sydney Faye Lemaire.
Jamal, congratulations.
Zoe Elizabeth Lenaweaver. Jennifer Vanessa Lopez.
Zoe, congratulations.
Sarah Marie Lovell. Abigail Elizabeth Lunetta. Marco Paul Lutza.
Abigail, congratulations.
Dylan Michael McGuire. Connor Stephen Mahoney.
Dylan, congratulations. Good job.
Austin Jacob Major. Benjamin Manchester Howell.
Good job, Austin. Congratulations.
Thomas Joseph Martirosian.
Benjamin, congratulations. Best of luck.
Jared Dale Matheny.
Best of luck. Yeah.
Valerie Ann Matthews.
Best of luck.
Shannon Catherine Matthew. James Patrick McBride.
Good job, Shannon. Congratulations. Best of luck. It's going on. Make me proud.
Alexander David McCabe Blaine.
James, congratulations.
Jesse June McNeil.
Congratulations.
Shayla Delaney McRae.
Jesse, congratulations. Very proud of you. Best of luck.
Xavier Paul McRae.
Congratulations. It's okay. Don't worry about it.
Alana Reese McSweeney. Mason Anthony Mello. Isabella Grace Menconi. Maximilian Shalefli Mioli. Cameron Nevaeh Mitchell. Devin Lily Mofford. Madison Emily Moreau. Tyler Joseph Marrera. Jalen Marie Morelli.
Congratulations.
Ryan James Morgan.
Congratulations.
Michael Valerio Morris.
Ryan, congratulations.
Cameron Joseph Morrison.
Mike, congratulations.
Abigail Ellen Moynihan. James Paul Murray III.
Best of luck to you. So proud of you.
Holly Elizabeth Nichols.
James, congratulations. Best of luck.
Prudence Rose O'Connor.
Holly, congratulations. Best of luck.
Omiye Irene Odaya.
Prudence, congratulations. Best of luck to you.
Kayla Shea O'Hara. Bradley George Oliveira.
Congratulations, Kayla. Best of luck to you.
Isabella Sophia O'Neill.
What's up, Bradley? Great job, buddy. Proud of you. Good job.
Sophia Diane O'Reilly.
Isabella, congratulations.
Lauren Alicia Orfanos.
Sophia, congratulations.
Thank you. Leah Marie Pagan. Anthony Palladino. Grover William Parham III. Nicholas Aiden Pelicano. Keegan Peltier. Sophia Nicole Perry. Bryce Stephen Purcell. Justin James Peters. Caroline Rose Pfeiffer. Nicole Miranda Pekarski. Jake Ryan Pickett. Yeva Paragas. Ava Gabrielle Polanski. Richard David Popson Jr. John Patrick Porter. Trinity Jewel Porter. Daniel Joseph Powers III. Matthew Richard Powers. Tina Louise Profetti. Olivia Bell Quinlan. Nicholas Sean Ray. Sophie Irene Raymondetta. Brianna Lynn Reed. Damon Wren. Mark Oliver Roberto. Ava Simone Roberts. Braden Frederick Roberts. Taylor Ella Robertson. Kiara Faith Rodriguez. Olivia Rose Rodriguez. Dylan Diomar Rodriguez. Lainey Jane Rodriguez Ferreira. Grace Aliana Rogach. Caitlin Elizabeth Ross. Nicholas Joseph Rossi. Corey Anthony Russo. Katie Grace Russo. Megan Elizabeth Ryan. Jack Michael Ryder. Casey Marie Ryder. Shaban Salim. Francesca Elizabeth Salvaggi. Caique de Oliveira Sampaio. Evan Mace Samsel.
Awesome job.
Savelle Arthur Samuel.
Evan,
Nina Marie Saris.
Wow. Great job.
Dominic Michael Cerro. Nina Francis Savino.
Good job.
Carly Ann Scannell. Kayla Alexandria Sears Eves. Rohan K. Sekri. Amanda Eleanor Sergio. Kayla Sophia Serrano. Sarah Elizabeth Shea. Suleiman Ahmed Sherif. Stephanie Gugorio Ferreira Silva. Stephanie Hosanna Simon. Zachary Thomas Sinclair. Christian Wayne Dalton Cisco. Tyler Nicholas Smith. Nathan Emmanuel Souza. Evan Patrick Spur. Jacob John Saint Ange. Ariana Elizabeth Stiles. Lee Veronica Stone. Kimberly Isabel Storm. Ella Rose Strusick. Aiden James Sullivan. Benjamin Ryan Sullivan. William Romalo Sutherland. Michael Paul Sweeney. Nina Elizabeth Tallarico. Benjamin Quinn Tansy. Catherine Pauline Taylor. Sophia Grace Tebow. Logan Joseph Thomas. Mia Kimberly Tierney. Cameron Peter Taranjo. Jason Patrick Traeger. Ella Brielle Trinanis. Julie Rita Vass. Brooke Dagan Victor. Connor James Walsh. Karina Faith Walsh. James Patrick Walsh. Grant Montgomery Watson. Matthew Aiden Weatherby. Mackenzie Elizabeth Weaver. Ryan Christopher Weiss. Lily Elizabeth Welch. Casey Patrick Wensley. Ryder Cooper Wayman. Jalen Janae Wilson. Chloe Grace Whitman. Adam Lee Warraby. Daniel Patrick Young. Eileen Zen. Gianna Marie Zine. And Alexandra Elizabeth Zumphy.
To all in attendance, we have reached the conclusion of the graduation ceremonies for the class of 2023. To the graduating seniors before me, you are a wonderful group of young adults, and I am certain you will go on to continue to do many great things. The past 4 years have flown by, and the successes this school has enjoyed are directly attributable to the effort you put forth. On behalf of the entire BR community, we congratulate you. To all in attendance, I am honored to present to you the graduating class of 2023.